We studied some of the questions related to area of sector and segment. Now we are going to learn the combination of this. So sector, segment, the combination will be there in the diagrams. So we need to find the area which they ask. So let's go to that exercise 12.3, first question here. Find the area of the shaded region in the figure. So this is the figure now. Here you have to find out the area of the shaded region. So now they have given PQ is equal to 24, PR is equal to 7 cm. PQ is equal to 24. So this is 24. PR is equal to 27 cm. PQ 24 cm. PR, sorry, 7 cm. PR is 7 cm. PR means this one. This is 7 cm. And O is the center of the circle. This is the center of the circle now. So you have to find out the area of the shaded region now. They have given this PQ. It's a card and PR is another card. So this is a diameter, then naturally this is a right angle triangle. Angle in a semicircle. So it is a 90 degree. This angle will be a 90 degree angle. So it's a right angle triangle with a 24 and 7. To find out the area of the circular region or the circle, we need to know the radius. How to find the radius? So here we need to find the diameter using Pythagoras theorem. So they are not given the radius here. So you can find out using Pythagoras theorem. You can find out the length of QR. So in triangle PQR, angle P is equal to 90 degree. Angle in a semicircle. So this opposite to this one must be hypotenuse. So QR square will be equal to PQ square plus PR square. So now PQ square is nothing but 24 square and this is 7 square. So now what is 24 into 24? You will get 576 plus 49. So now 9 plus 6 is 5. So then 7 plus 4 is 15. 8 plus 4 is 12. Then 625, that is QR square. So QR is equal to this square root of 625. Square root of 625 is 25. 25 into 25, 625, 25 centimeter. So you got this QR also, 25 centimeter. So QO or RO, so QO will be equal to RO, it is equal to 25 by 2 centimeter. So QO, QR is a diameter. So QO and RO both are equal, the radius of the circle, so it is 25 by 2 cm. So we want to find out the area of this shaded portion. How to find the area of the shaded portion of this also? Shaded area includes this also. You need to find the area of this semicircle minus the area of the triangle. Area of the shaded portion is equal to area of shaded portion is equal to area of semicircle minus area of triangle. Area of triangle PQR. Semicircle on QR. You can write area of semicircle on QR. Suppose if you take this area of this semicircle, it covers this complete area. If you subtract this area of triangle, then it gives the remaining area. So area of semicircle, it is equal to pi r square by 2. 1 by 2, pi value, 22 by 7, r square. Radius here, we calculate that is 25 by 2 radius. So you can substitute here 25 by 2 r square. Minus area of triangle here, it's a right angle triangle, you can use half into base into height, this is a 90 degree. So you can take this as base and this one as altitude, height. So half into base here I take 7, altitude here 24 centimeter. So this is base and this is altitude. Now you can simplify this one. So 1 by 2 into 22 by 7 into 25 by 2 into 25 by 2. So minus 2 1s are 2 2s are. So 7 into 12. So you can cancel this 2 1s are, 2 11s are. So now, So 11 into 625, 25 is divided by 7 into 4, 28. So minus 12 into 7, 84. So now multiply this 11 into 625. If you multiply this 11 into 625, you will get 6875 divided by 28 minus 84. So the final answer will be 161.53 centimeter square. If you simplify this, you will get this area of the shaded region. So 161.53. That is the area of the shaded portion. Number 2 here, find the area of the shaded region, this portion, ABC. ABC is ABDC. Shaded region in the figure. If radii of the two concentric circles with the center O are 7 cm and 14 cm. So that means from here to here it is 7 cm. Then from here to here it is 14 cm. This here the inner circle is having the radius of 7. The outer circle is having the radius of 14 cm respectively with the angle AOC is equal to this angle AOC is equal to 40 degree. Now it is very easy to find out the area of this shaded portion. As you need to find the area of the sector AOC minus area of sector BOD. So area of shaded portion is equal to, you can write area of shaded portion. Area of shaded portion, that is, you can mention that as ABDC. ABDC is equal to area of sector, that is the larger sector AOC, area of larger sector AOC minus area of that smaller sector BOD, area of sector BOD. So you have the formula theta divided by 360 into pi r square. Theta here, the angle it is 40 degree for both. So you can write 40 divided by 360 into pi r square. This is the radius of the larger circle, 14 square. Minus here theta, here again same angle, theta divided by 360. 40 divided by 360 into pi radius of the smaller circle, 7 square. Smaller circle is having radius 7 cm. So radius of the larger circle, then minus radius of the smaller circle we are doing. So here you can take common, 40 by 360 you can take common, and also pi you can take common. So inside you will get 14 square minus 7 square. So you can cancel here, 6100, it is 9 sir. So now 1 by 9 into 22 by 7, this is a square minus b square formula, 14 plus 7. Into 14 minus 7. So now you simplify this, 1 by 9 into 22 by 7, 14 plus 7, 21 into 14 minus 7, it is 7. Now you can simplify this one, 7 and 7 cancels. So 3 3s are 9, 3 7s are. So now 7 2s are 14. Then 72 is 14 plus 1, 15, 154 by 3. So now if you keep this in mixed fraction, 3 5s are 15, 3 1s are 51, 1 by 3 centimeter square. This is the area of the shaded portion. So area of this shaded portion, very simple, you look at this. This portion can be calculated by finding the area of this larger sector minus area of the smaller sector. Both are having the central angle, that is 40 degree. But the radius of the smaller one is 7, radius of the larger one is 14. Find out the area of larger, that is theta divided by 360 minus pi r square. 40 by 360 into pi into radius is 14 square. The smaller one, 40 by 360 same angle, pi into 7 square. If you simplify, you will get the area of the shaded portion. Find the area of the shaded region in the figure. If ABCD is a square, this is a square of side 14 cm. That means this edge is 14 cm, this is 14, 14 and 14. And APD and BPC are semicircles. This is one semicircle, BPC is another semicircle. So now you need to find they are intersecting, they are meeting each other at this point P. Okay, this is a common point. So now you have to find out the radius of this semicircle, which is drawn on the side AD as well as on BC, and also area of the square. Area of square minus area of two semicircles. Area of the shaded portion is equal to, we can write area of shaded portion. Is equal to area of square ABCD minus area of two semicircles on BC and AD. So now area of square, you know that is 14 into 14, side into side. Area of this square ABCD, side here 14 centimeter, therefore 14 into 14. Now area of this one semicircle is same as this area of the other one. So you can write here minus 2 times area of semicircle, that is 1 by 2 pi r square. 1 by 2 pi means 22 by 7. Radius here 14 by 2, radius will be 14 by 2, you can say 7 square. So now you multiply this 96 here, 196 minus, you can simplify this one, 2 and 2 cancel, 7 with this square. So then what is left out here? 22 into 7. So now 196 minus 7 2s are 14, but the 14 plus 1 154. 6 minus 4, 2, 9 minus 4, 9 minus 5, it is 4, 42 centimeter square. This is the area of the shaded portion now. This is the shaded portion. Very simple now. Find the area of this square, that is side into side. Area of these two semicircles you have to subtract. So area of this, you need to take the radius. So radius here, radius is equal to 14 by 2, it is 7 centimeter. So you can use this to find the area of this semicircle. Just you use, look at this, find the area of the shaded region in the figure. Let us see the diagram. This is the shaded region. Now where a circular arc of radius 6 cm has been drawn with the vertex O. So here this is the vertex O here. So with this vertex O, a circular, an arc is drawn like this with the radius of 6 cm. So this is 6 cm radius. So you are drawn on the, with vertex O as a center, you are drawn an arc. So next you see, has been drawn with the vertex O of an equilateral triangle OAB of side 12 cm. It's an equilateral triangle, that means this angle is 60 degree, this is 60 degree, this is 60 degree, and with the side it is 12 cm. This side is equal to 12 cm. Tell me how to find the area of the shaded region, any idea? Now this complete picture area you have to find out. How to find the area of the shaded region? Any idea?
Sir, first of all we have to find sectors, area of the sector, major sector, and then we can find the area of the equilateral triangle.
Okay, good. So now just you look at this. You can find out the area of this major sector. Look at this major sector. This is a major sector. You need to find out the area of the major sector. This includes only this much. So this much area only. Okay, this is the area you will get when you take the major sector. This much portion. Then add this equilateral triangle area. Then you will get the area of the shaded portion. So you can write area of shaded portion. So area of shaded portion is equal to, so area of sector, area of major sector, you can say major sector plus area of triangle OAB. Triangle OAB. So you know that it is, what is the measurement of this angle? Can you tell me it is, what is the measurement of this angle?
300.
So since this angle, they have not given directly, they told this is an equilateral triangle. So therefore this angle will be 60 degree, the remaining angle must be 300 degree. So you can write 300 degree is the angle of this sector divided by 360 degree into pi r square. So 22 pi 7 radius here it is given, it is 6 cm radius, 6 square. 300 over 360 pi r square plus area of triangle, you know that equilateral triangle formula, root 3 a square, that means 12 square divided by 4, root 3 a square by 4. So you can simplify here, 0, 0 cancels. So 6 5s are 30, 6 6 are 36. This is 6 and the square cancels. So you will left with 5 into 22 into 6 divided by 7 plus root 3. You can write 1.73 plus 12 into 12 by 4. 4 ones are 4 ones are 4 threes are. So you can write here 5 into 22 into 6 divided by 7 plus the second part 1.73 into 3 into 12, that much only. Now you can simplify this here, 5 6 are 30, this 22 by 7 you can write directly 3.14 plus 1.73, 12 3s are 36. If you multiply this one, you will get 3 4s are 12, 3 1s are 3 plus 1 4, 3 3s are 9. So this will be 94.2 plus 1.73 into 36. Get, if you multiply this 1.73 into 60, 36, you will get 62.28. Then add these two, you will get 8, 4, then 6, 15. 156.48 centimeter square. This is the area of the same portion. So very simple. So you can find the area of this major sector plus area of this equilateral triangle. So formula to find the area of equilateral, root 3 a square by 4. This is theta divided by 360 into pi r square. So directly I used the formula and found out the area of the shaded portion as 156.48 centimeter square. From each corner of a square, square here ABCD, from each corner of this square, there are four corners ABCD, from each corner of square, 4 centimeter side edge. This is a square of side 4 centimeter. From each corner of this square, a quadrant of a circle of radius 1 cm. This is 1 cm, 1 cm. 1 cm, 1 cm. So, 4 quadrants. So, 1 cm is cut actually. Is cut here from this square. This is a quadrant of radius 1 cm. This is a square of side 4 cm. And also a circle of diameter 2 cm. So, this is having 2 cm diameter. I shall find the area of the remaining portion of this square. So now to find out this, first you have to find out the area of square ABCD. You can do it separately. Area of square ABCD is equal to L into L. So that is 4 into 4, 16 centimeter square. Then area of one quadrant, area of a quadrant, it is theta divided by 360 into pi r square. So theta in a quadrant means it will be 90 degree, 90 into 360, 90 divided by 360, pi value 22 by 7, radius 1 square. So 9 ones are, 9 fours are. So you will get 1 by 4 into 22 by 7. So 1 square means it is 1 only. So 22 by 28. Centimeter square. This is the area of one quadrant. So we have area of four quadrants. Area of four quadrants. Area of quadrant, four quadrant is equal to 4 into 22 by 28. 4 ones are, 4 sevens are. So you will get 22 by 7 centimeter square. That is the area of four quadrant. Then area of circle. Area of circle at the center, it is pi r square. 22 by 7 into radius here, diameter is given, 2, therefore radius will become 1. So you will get 22 by 7 centimeter square. So now you got all the areas. So find out the shaded portion area, means area of square minus area of 4 quadrants and area of 1 circle. So you write here area of shaded portion. Area of shaded portion is equal to area of square minus area of 4 quadrants minus area of circle at the center. So this you got area of a square here, 4 into 4, 16 centimeter square. Then minus area of 4 quadrants, 4 quadrants 22 by 7, minus area of this circle also 22 by 7. So you can simplify this one, 16 minus, it becomes 44. So simplify this one, 7 is LCM. So 112 minus 44. So now subtract this one, 12 minus 4, 8, 10 minus 4, 6. So divided by 7. Keep in mixed fraction. 9 are 63, 5 by 7 centimeters square. This is the area of the shaded portion. Question number 6 here. Look at this. In a circular table cover of radius 32 cm, so that means from center to any vertex, so it is 32 cm. So now our design is formed leaving an equilateral triangle ABC. This is an equilateral triangle, means this angle is 60 degrees. So all are 60 degrees now. ABC middle of as shown in the figure. Find the area of the design. So you have to find out the area of this design. So if you take this, so this is also 32. This is the center. Now you have to find out the area of this design, means so three segments. This is one segment, another segment, so third segment. So you need to find the area of the segment. For this, see what is the central angle you should calculate, sector angle. From this sector angle, or otherwise, area of this circle minus area of an equilateral triangle, that is enough. So two different methods, area of this sector minus area of this triangle, it will be very lengthy, or area of this entire circle minus area of an equilateral triangle. Which one is easy? Second method, find the area of this circle and subtract area of triangle. Area of the design is equal to area of design is equal to area of circle minus area of triangle. Area of circle here 22 by 7 into radius given, that is 32 square, minus area of triangle, you know that it is equilateral triangle, root 3 a square. So side is not given. You need to calculate the side of this equilateral triangle. So you have to find out the area of side of an equilateral triangle. How can you find the area of an equilateral triangle? Drop the perpendicular here. We call this as D. Let OD, OD perpendicular to BC. So therefore it bisects the side BC. Use the trigonometric ratios now. This is 30 degree, 60 degree is divided into two equal parts, means this will become 30 degree now. Okay, so now this will be 60 degree, because this is 90 degree, means this will be 30 and 90 degree. So therefore angle, you can write DOC here, angle DOC here 30 degree, and angle D is equal to 90 degree. Angle D is equal to 90 degree. Use the Pythagoras, this one, trigonometric ratio, and find out the length of the side BC. So how to find the length of the side BC now? here hypotenuse use norm, what is 32? You have to calculate this inside. So cos 30 degrees, cos 30 degrees is equal to adjacent side DC by OC. First, what is cos 30 degree? What is cos 30? It is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2. So here DC we need to calculate, divided by 32. So therefore DC will be equal to 32 into root 3 by 2. 2 1s are 2 16s are. DC is equal to 16 root 3. But I want length BC. BC is equal to 2 times DC. So 2 times 16 root 3. That is 32 root 3 centimeter. So that is the length of the side BC. So you calculated the length of the equilateral triangle, that is 32 root 3. So you pursue root 3 a square, 32 root 3 whole square divided by 4. Root 3 a square by 4. So you can simplify here, 22 by 7 into 32 into 32 minus this will be root 3 only. This becomes 3 into root 3 square means 3. So 32 into 32 divided by 4. You can take common here. 32 into 32 is common. If you take 32 into 32 common, inside the bracket you will be left with 22 by 7 minus this becomes 3 into 1.73. Root 3 value is 1.73 divided by 4. So simplify this one. 32 into 32. So this value is 3.14 minus 3 3s are 9, 3 7s are 21, 2, 5.19 divided by 4. Simplify this now. See, if you take LCM and simplify, you will get this one 7.37, then 4 1s are 4 8s are. So then 8 2s are 16. 1, 8 3s are 24, plus 1, 25, 256, 256 into 7.37. So what is the answer you will get? Area is equal to 256 into 7.37. Find the product. So that is the area of the shaded design. Area of the design is 1886.72. So that is the area. Next question here. In the figure, ABCD is a square of side 14 cm with the centers ABCD. ABCD is a square with the centers as AB and CD. So four circles are drawn such that the circles touch externally two of the remaining circles. Here they are touching each other at one. They are intersecting at one point. So they are touching each other. When we draw the circles at four corners of the square, find the area of the shaded region. So here the square of side 14 cm, that is the data that they have given. So this length AB is equal to 14 cm. 14 cm, that is the data that they have given. Now you have to find out the area of the shaded region now. To find the area of the shaded region, area of this square minus area of this quadrant, four quadrants. Find out the area of the square. So first let us find out the area of square. Area of square ABCD. It is equal to L into L, 14 into 14. So 196 centimeter square. That is the area of the square ABCD. So area of quadrant. Area of quadrant at A. So at A this quadrant, you can find out the area of this quadrant. So theta divided by 360 into pi r square. Here 90 divided by 360. Pi value 22 by 7. Radius is half of this one because they are intersecting at each other when we draw these two circles with A and B, therefore it must be half. This is 7. This is 7. So you can write 7 into 7. If you simplify this one, 9 ones are 9, 4s are 707 cancers. So then 2s are 2, 11s are 77.2 centimeters square. Since we have 4 quadrants, so you can calculate area of 4 quadrants. Area of 4 quadrants is equal to 4 into each quadrant measures 77.2. 2 1s are 2 2s are, then it is 2 7s are 14, so then 15. 154 centimeters square. This is the area of 4 quadrants. So now area of shaded portion is equal to area of square minus area of 4 quadrants. Square area, you got it 196. This 4 quadrants 154. So answer is 42 centimeters square. That is the area of this shaded portion at the center. Figure depicts a racing track whose left and right ends are semicircular. See, now here you can see the diagram. This is a racing track. This left portion and right portion is a semicircle in shape, and the distance between the two inner parallel line segments is 60 meter. This length is given 60 meter, and also 106 meter long. This length is 106 meter from year to year. 106, and the width of the track is 10 meter. Using this, find the distance around the track along the inner edge. So this length only you have to find out, inner edge. So distance around the track. So first question, the solution to the first question. How to find this distance? This distance. Inner edge of this track. What is this length? It is 106. This is 106 means this is also 106. Parallel track, parallel line. We have 2 106 meter. And since this is given 60 meter, you can find out the length of this semicircle. So using this, you have to find out the radius. So radius of the arc. Here radius here. So radius of arc is equal to 60.2, 30 centimeter. So length of this track, length of the track is equal to 2 parallel sides plus length of 2 arcs at ends. So we need to find out the length of 2 arcs at the ends. These 2 arc length we have to find out. This length and this length. So here 2 times 106 parallel lines, 2 times 106 plus we have 2 arcs, 2 into